Greetings. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Is Mohammed mentioned in the Bible, specifically in the Song of Solomon, chapter 5, verse 16? Let's take a careful look at what the verse says. His mouth is most sweet, yea, he is altogether lovely. This is my beloved, and this is my friend, O daughters of Jerusalem. Well, people who claim Muhammad is in the scripture would have you see the name Muhammad right there over those two words, altogether lovely. Does that make it clear? Yeah, probably not. So why is there this confusion? The word translated into English as altogether lovely comes from the Hebrew word Machmad. Is Machmad the name Mohammed? Well, if you listen to a dramatic, flourishing speaker like Achmed Deedat, he will make that claim, and that's one of his errors. Could the Hebrew word Machmad really be a secret reference to a man named Mohammed? Let's look at the context. That's what's going to determine everything. Song of Solomon, chapter 5. Verse 1 begins, I am come into my garden, my sister, my spouse. I have gathered my myrrh with my spice. I have eaten my honeycomb with my honey. I have drunk my wine with my milk. Eat, O friends, drink, yea, drink abundantly, O beloved. I sleep, but my heart wakes. It is the voice of my beloved that knocks, saying, open to me, my sister, my love, my dove, my undefiled. For my head is filled with dew and my locks with the drops of the night. This is a guy who's thinking about a girl he wants to have relations with. What does she say? I have put off my coat. How shall I put it on? I have washed my feet. How shall I defile them? My beloved put in his hand by the hole of the door, and my heart was moved for him. This is a girl who also is yearning for relations with her man. I rose up to open to my beloved, and my hands dropped with myrrh, and my fingers with sweet-smelling myrrh upon the handles of the lock. I opened to my beloved, but my beloved had withdrawn himself and was gone. My soul failed when he spoke. I sought him, but I could not find him. I called him, but he gave me no answer. My beloved is white and ruddy, the most chief among 10,000. His head is as most fine gold. His locks are bushy and black as a raven. His eyes are as the eyes of doves by the rivers of waters, washed with milk and fitly set. His cheeks are as a bed of spices, his sweet flowers, his lips like lilies, dropping sweet-smelling myrrh. His hands are as gold rings, set with beryl, and his belly is bright ivory overlaid with sapphire. His legs are pillars of marble, set upon sockets of fine gold. His countenance is as Lebanon, excellent as the cedars. His mouth is most sweet, yea, as he is altogether lovely. This is my beloved, and this is my friend, O daughters of Jerusalem. So we see here that she's just given 5 or 6 verses describing her man, every attribute, and she concludes with, he is altogether lovely. There is nothing about him that is repelling or undesirable. It makes no sense to try and imagine a name being placed here. His name is Muhammad. It just doesn't make any sense. So what is the context? Song of Solomon is a book of sensual love, of erotic love, of passion, yearning. Does the context fit even thinking this is Muhammad? Did Muhammad drink and invite his bride to drink? Think about it. Did Muhammad say, I have drunk my wine with my milk? Eat, O friends, drink, yea, drink abundantly, O beloved. Is he really telling his wife to get drunk? Is Song of Solomon a prophecy of a coming prophet? No, it is not. Think about it. These are just all the reasons why it is inappropriate and disrespectful to the Word of God to even try and claim that the letters of the word Machmad are the name Mohammed. Could 516 refer to Mohammed? There's not a chance on earth. But why make such a claim? Because of need? Hope? Maybe desperation? Specifically, it is to defend Mohammed and the Quran. But why? Because Mohammed claimed he was mentioned in the Torah and Bible. So Mohammed's followers must produce a reference, or it proves that Mohammed was not a prophet from the living God. Is Mohammed mentioned in Song of Solomon 5:16? No, he is not. It is crystal clear. There is no question. It is a book of erotic love, and it is a woman speaking of her lover, and the Hebrew word Machmad is not the name of Mohammed. If you are a Christian, do not get tricked by these deceptive and provably false claims of Mohammed in the Bible. If you call yourself Muslim, try to think with the mind that God has given you. If Mohammed is the last prophet, will he be revealed as a drinker, as is the man in verse 1? Will he be revealed by the random occurrence of four Hebrew characters? Probably not. Is this really how God would reveal his last and presumably most important prophet? No, it is not. This verse cannot and does not refer to Muhammad. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.